Samavati was born into a happy and harmonious family. She was very beautiful and very kind to all her playmates. However, tragedy struck their town. An infectious epidemic broke out in their village, taking the lives of many people and sickening others. Samavati and her parents had no choice but to flee their hometown. Samavati's father knew a finance minister named Kosaka in the city of Kosampi. He decided to bring his family there in hopes that Kosaka would take them in. But when they arrived in Kosampi, they decided to try to survive on the streets as long as they could in order not to burden Kosaka. They found a small area and huddled together at night to keep warm. In Kosampi, Kosaka had erected a public alms hall that provided soup, rice, and curry to refugees. Samawadi's family sent her to go get some food for them. When she arrived at the hall, she saw that it was disorganized and chaotic. On the first day, the official who ran the center immediately noticed a cute little girl who asked for 3 bowls of food. He figured that she must be very hungry. On the second day, he saw her with only 2 bowls and noticed that this time, she only asked for 2 bowls. On the third day, the little girl came back with only 1 bowl. The official laughed out loud and said, "Young miss, you finally know how much your little belly can hold." Little Samavati then explained, "No, sir. On the first day, I came to get food for my father, my mother, and for myself. However, on that day, my father succumbed to the plague and died. On the second day, I only needed food for my mother and me. But on that day, my mother died of the plague also. And today, I am all that remains, so I only need 1 portion." The official felt so ashamed for teasing the young girl. Realizing that she was all alone in the world, he also felt immense compassion for her plight. So he offered to adopt her as his daughter, and Samavati was happy to accept. Samavati immediately began helping her foster father with the distribution of food and care for the refugees. Thanks to her efficiency and circumspection, the distribution center was organized and orderly. There were no more fights, line cuttings, or arguments. Kosaka, the king's finance minister, heard about the positive changes at the distribution center and called the official in to compliment him. The official modestly replied that it was not his doing, but rather his new adopted daughter's work. And thus, Kosaka finally met Samavati. He was so impressed by her demeanor that he adopted her and brought her to live with him in his grand house. The official was reluctant to part with Samavati, but did not want to stand in the way of her fortune. Samavati was now the heiress to a massive fortune and a vast estate. One day, King Udena visited Kosaka and met Samavati. King Udena immediately fell in love with her. After the king got home, he sent a messenger to ask for Kosaka to give Samavati to him in marriage. Kosaka was faced with a difficult decision. He had grown very fond of Samavati and could not imagine life without her. She had brought so much joy and love to his life that he could not live without her. However, he knew the king had a fierce and quick temper. His refusal could lead to dire results. But in the end, his attachment to Samavati prevailed, and he said, "Better to die than to live without Samavati." When the king received news of Kosaka's refusal, he flew into a rage. He stripped Kosaka of his position, banned him from the kingdom, and did not allow Samavati to accompany him. The king confiscated all of Kosaka's lands and property and boarded up his mansion. When Samavati heard the news, she was heartbroken. It pained her to think that Kosaka suffered because of her. Not only did he lose his position, but also his country and all of his belongings. She reflected on all of Kosaka's kindness, love, and care, and felt great gratitude. So, out of compassion for her adopted father, Samavati volunteered to marry the king in order to end the dispute. She went to the palace and told the king herself. Her many servants refused to leave her side and went with her. The king was overjoyed and accepted Samavati and her maidservants into the palace. He rescinded his past orders and restored Kosaka to his previous position, along with his property and estates. King Udena eventually went on to have three wives, Queen Samavati, Vasuladatta, and Makantiya. Queen Samavati sent her maidservant Kuchutara to go buy flowers every day. One day, Kuchutara came back with wonderful news. She had encountered the Buddha and listened to his sermon. After Queen Samavati heard the contents of the Buddha's teachings, the queen and all 500 maidservants became sotapanas, stream enterers. Queen Samavati was a devout Buddhist. She took every opportunity she had to go give alms and charity and otherwise support Buddhism. However, life in the palace was not easy. Makantiya had evil in her heart and plotted to destroy Buddhism. Since Queen Samavati was a student of the Buddha, she too was a target. Eventually, Queen Samavati and her 500 maidservants fell victim to one of Makantiya's plots. They were trapped in their private palace, and the building was set ablaze. Instead of succumbing to fear and distress, they decided to use the last moments of their lives to contemplate the Buddha's teachings. Many of them were able to achieve higher levels of enlightenment before death.
What do you think the moral of this story is?
We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.